7 o'clock तक पक्का आ जाऊंगी।
7 o'clock
तो आजकल समय से रात भी नहीं होती वहाँ, प्लीज 7:00
जो रूल्स है वैसे भी तुम्हारे पापा गुस्सा करेंगे, तुम्हें 6 बजे आना है और आना ही पड़ेगा।
प्लीज मैं ठीक है, मैं 6:50 तक आ जाऊँगी।
6 o'clock
अच्छा ठीक है मैं आ
जाऊँगी। पहनती क्या जा रही हो?
मैं आपको बता दूँगी ना, मैं जाऊँगी।
बेटा तुम अकेले रात को जा रही हो बाहर, तुम्हें कुछ ढंग के कपड़े ही पहन के जाना है।
अच्छा ठीक है मैं
बेटा
कब तक आओगे?
पता नहीं मामा, प्लान कोई फिक्स नहीं, बता दूंगा।
अच्छा मुझे कॉल करके बता
देना। नॉट पहले से कोई रेस्ट्रिक्शन नहीं है, जितनी सारी रेस्ट्रिक्शन
लड़की हो तुम्हें लिमिट में रहना है।
क्या करें, कोई इज्जत ही नहीं बची।
मैंने सुबह भी इसे बाहर जाने से मना किया था, मगर मेरी सुनता हुआ नहीं आया। आप लोगों को बस सोसाइटी की पड़ी है, मेरे साथ क्या हुआ उसे किसी को कोई परवाह नहीं है।
हम क्योंकि हमें इसी सोसाइटी में रहना है।
सुना शर्मा जी की बेटी ने हम के साथ क्या हुआ?
क्या हुआ?
अरे सुना है कल ही कुछ गुंडों ने खड़ी सड़क पे उसका बदतमीजी करी।
ये तो होना ही था, उसके कपड़े देखे थे वो कैसे पहनती थी,
रात रात को घूम रही होती है सड़कों पे। ये बात सही है,
ये लड़कियां ही ना समझती नहीं है बात।
उस दिन मैंने उसको किसी लड़के के साथ बाइक पे देखा था, रात को पीछे जाती बैठ के जा रही थी उसके साथ, और क्या कपड़े पहने थे। ये सब ठंड में भी ये सब गलत है उसकी माँ बाप की भी,
कुछ कर गुजरने को खून चला खून चला, आंखों के शीशे में उतरने को खून चला, बदन से टपक कर जमीन से
कैन फाइट यू, यू नीड अ बिग फाइट फॉर दिस, इट्स नॉट अ इजी थिंग, इजी जॉब यू हैव टू फाइट।
Is there anything that you can do at the domestic level to give importance to women?
You have to think young generation, intelligent, genius, IQ is too high.
cultural aspects, without even realizing it, will be misogynistic, whether it's stereotypes or whether it's certain little things that let's say that women can't do something and men can't do something.
Yeah.
Like, any kind of stereotype or any kind of whatever it's sexist and it's honestly contributes to misogyny. And I think the solution is complete equality.
So what are the preventive measures? I mean, at some domestic level, what can we do? What can as we citizens, what can we do?
Preventive measures. Yeah. I think well laws are in place, and then I think we can all they don't work obviously.
Yeah.
But I mean, see, there are a lot. You have to look at the political aspects, and then there are like a lot of aspects that need to be taken under consideration, and once that is, then you realize it's actually not that easy, because for example the law that we have right now and the way cases are held for rape and everything, a lot of things are wrong, right? But then those can be fixed. But I think the ultimate solution is a long-term cultural transformation. That is.
And what are your views? That what can we take steps to make the Delhi safe for women, for girls?
For girls, Delhi safe for girls. Because I don't see it happening in a long, long time, honestly.
What can we do for that?
I think it really starts from home. Once males start respecting women, I think half the problem is solved. So it's really in your head, in your mind. It's nowhere else.
That means for you, the socialization is more important for all these things.
Yeah, I think awareness is very important. You know, it should start from school. There should be classes which teach gender equality. There should be lessons given on how to be chivalry. Let's call it chivalry. How to be chivalrous to women, what one should do to respect women. So I think that's where it starts. You give moral science lectures and then you teach stupid stuff in moral science, which makes no sense.
Arjun.
Remember what we were taught in moral science classes. So I think moral science classes should include subjects like these, road safety, how you respect elders, how you respect women, gender equality. So it should start from the basic education that students are given. I think that's where it begins.
The women should be helped in their shores, in the house. Like, they shouldn't say, like, this poor woman, she's working also, and then she comes home and she does the housework. So there should be some kind of, you know, a mindset change in the in-laws and in the family. That is, otherwise, you know, the mother is pounded with extra work. She's doing it without complaining. That's how it is. And we don't offer any resistance. I was a working woman. But for me, like, it was different because it was my children, my mother-in-law, my husband. They would all come and, you know, kind of help me out. But I know of other women and all that. They would actually toil at work. You can see them actually sleeping in the buses and all that. And poor things, they have to come back at home and work there also.
All the girls go through with that. But what we can do, we have to raise a voice at the same time, because most of the girls, because I also been in a situation, I have a friend who never raised her voice. So for her, always on her behalf, I raise her voice. So at the same time, for her, she needs to raise her voice so that the people does not think that, okay, she is weak, I can take advantage. So first of all, she needs to raise her voice. Whosoever is there, raise her voice. If you need to slap the boy or the person who's her. I think so, because this is the thing I done my job.
And what do you think a government should do to stop these crimes?
Not the big laws, but basic things that can be done.
I think so is that police patrolling should be there, because most of the places, the crowded places, if you go around 7, 8 or 9 o'clock, it's a time which girls like to go out also. But that's the time where if there is no police patrolling, then nobody is there to secure you. If you yourself like to raise the voice and nobody comes and help you out, girl feeling kind of insecure. So I think the police patrolling should be there at the same time, so the girl could feel secure. So I myself, if somebody is there to help me out, I would surely raise the voice high. Because the boys are generally talk loud and they run away, they touch and they run away. At that tough point of time, the help should be there. Yes, help should be there. Your friends are there, it's helpful at that time to raise the voice. So I think the police patrolling should be there. More of people convinced should be there to secure your life.
बड़ी सीटी सुने कर आहिस्ता आहिस्ता सवालों की उंगली जवाबों की मुट्ठी संग लेकर
बड़ी बात हो गई और उनकी हिम्मत कैसी वेट करेंगे, तो मुझे एक फोन करके मैं वहाँ पहुँच जाऊँगा। करने वाले थे तो उसको मुझे तो उसके फॉर्म करने छोड़ने पड़े और तुम यहाँ तक कैसे पीछे रह आए तुम मुझे पहुँचाने तुम नहीं हो ना
लेकिन मैंने अब है जीना सीख लिया
Yeah.